Welcome to our brief video on how to use Boolean operators. Today we are going to learn how to search a library database faster and with more precision. How so, do you ask? With the basics of Boolean operators. With the use of common Boolean operators such as AND, OR, and NOT, we will be able to efficiently research the Salem Witch Trials for your project. Let's get started. First, it is important to understand how Boolean operators work. Usually, when we use the word AND in a sentence, we get more things. When we use the word OR in a sentence, we get less things. However, when using the Boolean AND in a database search, we will get less results. While using the Boolean OR will give us more results. How can this be so? Let me show you what I mean by using a table full of Halloween candy. Some of the candies on the table contain chocolate, some contain caramel, some contain both, and some contain neither. A Boolean search of chocolate or caramel will fill the Halloween container with all the candy that contains chocolate and all the candy that contains caramel. This includes the candy that contains both chocolate and caramel too, like the Snickers and the Milky Way. So many options! A Boolean search of chocolate and caramel will fill the Halloween container only with the candy that contains both chocolate and caramel, the Milky Way and the Snickers. So your Boolean AND search has given you much less candy and narrowing down the treats you're craving. For a further example, what if we are craving caramel and chocolate but have peanut allergies? The Boolean search with NOT will take away results that include something I do not need. In this case, a Boolean search of chocolate and caramel, not nuts, will eliminate candy that contains nuts. Chocolate and caramel will fill the Halloween container only with the candy that contain both chocolate and caramel, but now the NOT operator will take out any candy that has nuts. Therefore, the Snickers bar is eliminated and you only end up with the Milky Way bar when using this search. Notice that we broke the search up into two steps, with the AND operator first, and the NOT operator second. This is because the parentheses dictate the order of operation. Finally, we uncovered what we are really craving by methodically narrowing down our selection. While previously exampled with candy, Boolean operators are a key strategy and tool to apply to all of your future searches. Now let's apply what we learned about the AND, OR, and NOT Boolean operators to help you begin your research on the Salem Witch Trials in the library database. Now let's do a search using Salem and Witch and Trial. This search will retrieve only the sources that contain all three terms, Salem, Witch, and Trial. This Boolean AND search brought up 10,220 sources. As you can see, the sources are specifically about the Salem Witch Trials. With Boolean operators, we can continue our searching even further. While OR can bring in numerous results, it also ensures that your search pulls in all relevant sources that may be sorted by a similar, yet different keyword. What if a source spoke to witchcraft and not witch? We can include both words to ensure we have all applicable sources. Salem and, parentheses, witch or witchcraft, end parentheses, and trials. This search, which used OR, brought in more sources, 12,079 to be exact. We are ensuring that we are not missing any useful resources. As your school project focuses on the history of the witch trials, let's look to remove any historical fiction novels from our search. How do we begin to remove any information we do not need? With the NOT Boolean operator. Let's add another field and select NOT Fiction. Note how our search has begun to narrow down our sources to 6,431. These examples show the power of Boolean operator strategies, which can be used for all of our future database searches. Now remember, the Boolean operator AND gives you less, while the Boolean operator OR gives you more.